Hello dear students, today we are going to see how to perform microbiological assay by cup, plate and filter disc method. So the aim for today's practical is to perform microbiological assay of given antibiotic by cup, plate and filter. The requirement for the practicals are: the culture required is Bacillus subtilis, since we are using the antibiotic, that is the streptomycin, so the test microorganism used is Bacillus subtilis. Then antibiotic assay medium, distilled water. Apparatus required is petri plate, test tube, glass spreader, micropipette or pipette, cork borer, conical flask, filter disc. Equipment required is autoclave and incubator. So microbiological assay, it may be defined as the qualitative or quantitative determination of any chemical compound from a simple or even complex material with the use of microorganism. So any agent which influences the microorganism, that is the growth, or either they reduce the growth or they increase the growth. So any material which is affecting, or any chemical agent which is affecting the growth of the microorganism, they can be standardized by using this microbiological assay. So they are as accurate as your chemical method. It is simple, specific, inexpensive and convenient method. It requires less space, labor, time and material. They are useful in detecting the potency of antibiotics and their preparation. Advantages include: it is simple, specific, minimum requirement of space, labor, materials and time, inexpensive and convenient method. Disadvantages include: it requires skilled technician, proper calibration, less reproducible results are obtained by this method, chances of great error, and not used if a good alternative physical or chemical assay is available considering the conditions required. So now we'll see the microbiological assay of antibiotic. So it is based on a comparison of inhibition of growth of microorganism shown by the measured concentration of the antibiotic under examination with that produced by known concentration of the standard preparation of antibiotic. So just compare the zone of inhibition shown by the test antibiotic with the standard antibiotic, and that will help you to determine the potency of the test antibiotic. So what are the various reagents used for the microbiological assay of antibiotic? That is the media used. So media has to be prepared for the specified test organism required for the assay as per the ingredients which are given in the IP according to the requirements of the test organism. So media can be prepared by dissolving the ingredients which are given in the table, and the pH is adjusted using 1 molar sodium hydroxide or 1 molar hydrochloric acid. So here you can see there are 10 medias available. So depending on the test microorganism which is required, you have to select the media which is to be used for a particular microbiological assay. Preparation of standard solution. Standard preparation is any authentic sample whose potency is known. And to prepare the stock solution, dissolve the quantity which will be specified in the IP and then dilute it to the required concentration as indicated, and store in refrigerator and use within the period indicated. So likewise here you can see This is the assay method A or B is used. Then initial solvent used for the stock solution. For streptomycin, it is water. Then how much should be the concentration of the stock solution? That is 1 mg/mL. Then for the taste solution, the dilution used is again the water. And this is the median dose required for the turbidimetric method, which is also given for that particular antibiotic. Then second reagent required is buffer solution. So buffer is required to maintain the pH of the medium. So this buffer can be produced by dissolving the dipotassium hydrogen phosphate and potassium dihydrogen phosphate in sufficient water and adjusting the volume with 8 molar phosphoric acid or 10 molar sodium hydroxide. So depending on the buffer specified in the IP, you can select any buffer. Sample solution, as I have told you, from the information available in IP, you have to prepare the sample solution. Then next reagent is the taste microorganism required. The taste microorganism for each antibiotic is specified in the pharmacopoeias. So here you can see this is the taste microorganism for the given antibiotic. Now for streptomycin, we require the Bacillus subtilis, and therefore we have used the Bacillus subtilis as a taste microorganism for the microbiological assay. So two methods are used for microbiological assay. The first method is cylinder plate or cup plate method. And second is tube assay or turbidimetric method. So we'll see the first one, that is we are going to perform the practical by this method, that is the curved plate or cylinder plate method. So the principle of this method is what? Diffusion of an antibiotic from a vertical cavity or cylinder through the solidified agar layer in petri plate, and after the diffusion takes place, the microorganism shows a zone of inhibition because the growth gets inhibited in the circular area or zone around the cavity which contains the solution of the antibiotic. So this method is also known as agar diffusion method. So procedure is the nutrient agar is melted, cooled suitably and poured into the petri dish. Then spread 0.2 ml of known concentration of inoculum on the surface of the solidified agar using spread plate technique. Then prepare cups and cavities using this sterile cork borer. Equal volume of antibiotic, that is the different dilutions of the standard antibiotic and taste antibiotic, is poured into the cups of the agar plate and then incubated at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. If the antibiotic has any antibacterial effect, it will show the zone of inhibition. Then accurately measure the diameter of zone of inhibition and calculate the result. Then plot a graph of zone of inhibition versus log concentration of antibiotic and determine the unknown concentration of antibiotic. So likewise, you will get the zone of inhibition. Just mark it with the marker and measure the zone of inhibition. So likewise, you will have to plot a graph, that is the log concentration of antibiotic and diameter of zone of inhibition. So based on zone of inhibition, you will get of the taste antibiotic. You just have to interpolate it on x-axis and you will get the concentration of the taste antibiotic. Then comes the second method, that is turbidimetric or tube assay method. So this method has an advantage that the incubation period required is very short, that is 3 to 4 hours, but there is a possibility of solvent residues or other inhibitory substances may present in this assay, and they may affect the result of this assay And second is, it is not recommended for cloudy or turbid preparation since we are determining the activity based on the turbidity. So first you have to prepare five different concentration of the standard solution by diluting it from the stock solution. Then you have to select the median concentration and prepare the unknown solution in considering the median concentration. Then 1 ml of each of the standard solution and the test solution is placed into the test tube. Then 9 ml of the nutrient medium, which is previously seeded with the test microorganism, is added into the each of the test tube. At the same time, you have to prepare 3 control tube, one containing uninoculated culture medium, second containing inoculated culture medium which act as a culture control, and the third contains inoculated culture medium plus 0.5 ml of dilute formaldehyde solution, which is also known as the blank, which will be required for the measurement of absorbance. So place all tubes in an incubator or incubator water bath at specified temperature for 3 to 4 hours, and after incubation you have to add 0.5 ml of dilute formaldehyde solution to each of the tube. Then measure the growth of test microorganism by determining the absorbance at 530 nanometer against the blank, and then again you have to plot the graph, and you will get on x-axis that is the concentration, and on y-axis you will get the absorbance, and based on that absorbance determine the concentration of the unknown sample. So this is the image of the how to perform the turbidimetric method. Instead of using one concentration of the test antibiotic, this image contains the 5 concentration of the test antibiotic. So you can go likewise also, or you can go that is the 5 concentration of the standard and 1 concentration of the test, that is 1 test tube of the test. So now we will see the procedure for performing the microbiological assay of streptomycin. Hello dear students, so today we are going to perform the microbiological assay of antibiotic by cup plate and filter disc method. So today we are going to perform the microbiological assay of antibiotic, that is the streptomycin sulfate, by cup plate as well as filter disc method. Now cup plate method, it is also known as agar diffusion method, because agar the antibiotic solution, it diffuses into the agar. And filter disc method, it is also known as disc diffusion, because the antibiotic disc, it diffuses its solution into the agar, and due to the diffusion it shows the zone of inhibition. Okay, now we will see the procedure. So first is, you have to label the agar plate and the test tubes. Okay, so suppose you are preparing the agar plate, so wherever you want to place the disc or wherever you want to make the cavities, you have to label it likewise. So we are going to prepare this dilution, so I have labeled it with this, and also you can write a name of antibiotic if you want, in case you are performing the microbiological assay of multiple plates. Okay, so similarly you have to label the test tubes also. Okay, second, you have to prepare the agar plate. So in this preparation of agar plate, you have to first prepare the agar plate by adding the molten agar, and second thing you have to do, you have to add the test microorganism by the spread plate technique. The test microorganism that is specific to the particular antibiotics, so test microorganism which is specific to streptomycin, it is the Bacillus subtilis. So with the help of this bacteria we are going to add it here. And the medium which is required for this, for the streptomycin, the medium required is medium
Okay, so out of the 10 mediums which are specified in the IP, the medium which is required for the microbiological assay of streptomycin sulfate, it is the medium A. So you have to prepare the medium A and then add it into the agar plate. Okay, so this is all about the preparation of agar plate. Okay, then comes the next one. So whichever method you are applying, like if you are preparing it by cup plate method, you have to prepare the cavities with the help of sterile cork borer. Or you can take a syringe and cut it. Of course, the syringe should be sterilized and cut it, as I will show you in the practical. Okay, and make the cavities. Or you can prepare a filter disc. Okay, so depending on the method you are applying, either make cavities or prepare the filter disc. Okay, then you have to prepare the dilutions. For the preparation of dilutions, in case of the streptomycin, you have to add 256 milligram of the standard drug in 100 ml of water, and when you will pipette out 1 ml from it and dilute it to 100 ml, then you can say this solution was known as 20 units per ml. Okay, so you do not require this solution. You can prepare the dilutions of 10, then 12, 14 and 16 for the standard. We have taken 4 dilutions as per the dimensions of our plate. Okay, otherwise the zone of inhibition can get overlapped. Okay, so as per the calculations, if 1 ml in gives 20 units in 100 ml, so we are preparing 10 ml of dilutions. So 0.1 ml will be required if you want to prepare the 20 units in 10 ml. Okay, so 1 ml in 100 ml gives how much? 20 units. If I want to make it 10 ml, how much I will take? 0.1 ml in 10 ml gives again the 20 units. Okay, so likewise I am preparing the dilutions. Now I want to prepare 10 units and that should be 10 ml solution. Okay, so for 20 units I require 0.1 ml. So for 10 units I will require 0.05 ml. So how I will prepare the dilution? I will take 0.05 ml of the streptomycin stock solution and I will dilute it to 10 ml with sterile water. Water is used as a diluent for the microbiological assay of streptomycin. Okay, so for 10 unit I will take 0.05 ml, for 12 I will take 0.06, for 14 I will take 0.07, and for 16 I will take 0.08. so likewise you have to prepare the dilutions. Okay, then comes the next step, that is adding petri plate. The petri plate, it will either you can add it in cavities by using the micro pipette or the pipette, or you can just dip the filter disc into the test tubes of this solution of these dilutions, and then with the help of forceps, sterile forceps, you can add this disc, place it on the surface of the agar. So disc, slowly you will place it like this. Okay, so likewise you have to add the dilutions in the petri plate as per the labels given. Okay, similarly you have to prepare the unknown dilution. You can take any media concentration within this range of the unknown and prepare approximately the concentration of the unknown or the taste antibiotic to prepare the so that you can determine whether the taste antibiotic has showing the similar zone of inhibition or not. Okay, so after preparing the dilutions of the taste and the standard, you have to add both these dilutions into the petri plate using pipette or forceps in case of disc diffuser, After that, you have to refrigerate it for 2 hours for the diffusion of the antibiotic, and after 2 hours, you have to incubate it for 32 to 35 degrees Celsius for 24 to 48 hours. Okay, so this is all about the procedure of microbiological assay of antibiotic. Now we will see how to perform the microbiological assay by couplet method and filter disc method. So the requirements for this are, that is the Petri plate, then micropipette for the preparation of dilutions. These are the taste tubes. Then pipette, 10 ml volumetric flask, because we are going to prepare 10 ml of the dilution. Nichrome wire loop, marker. Then we are going to perform the microbiological assay of streptomycin. So for that we require the streptomycin. Forceps for the filter disc method. Spreader, because we are going to prepare the plate by spread plate technique. Then this is the sample, bacterial sample, that is the Bacillus subtilis is the test microorganism which is used for the microbiological assay. And molten nutrient agar. In addition to this, we require this filter disc, which will be placed on the agar medium for the disc diffusion method. The very first step while performing the practical is to sterilize the platform. So now this is the platform where I am going to perform the practical. So first of all, I have thoroughly cleaned the platform, here you can see. And now I will disinfect it using the alcohol. So here you can see I have used the ethanol. So I will take a small portion of the cotton and then I will take ethanol and disinfect the platform where I have to perform the practical. Make sure your burners are off while performing this disinfection process, otherwise the alcohol can catch the fire. So just clean the platform properly and allow the alcohol to evaporate. Now here you can see the alcohol has vaporized and this section is completely sterilized. Now we will need to maintain the sterilized air, that is the air environment should be sterilized. So for that, I will switch on the burners and now I will perform the practical in between these two burners. So whatever my requirements are, or if you require taste tube, I will place in between these two burners. So complete sterile environment will be maintained in between these two burners, and then I will perform the practical here. Now first of all, after disinfection, we will name the plates. Now we are going to prepare the 4 dilutions. So I will label the plates like 10, 12, 14 and 16, and here I will have my unknown. Similarly, I will label this second plate for the disc
diffusion method.
So likewise, I have labeled the plates. Now I am going to label the test tube similarly. So this will become 12, 14, 16. So here you can see I have labeled the test tube. Now the plates are kept ready. Now we will prepare the dilutions. Now for the dilutions, I have prepared this stock solution of streptomycin by dissolving 256 milligram in 100 ml of water, and this is the sterile water which is used for the dilution. Now our first dilution is 10 units per ml. So for 10 units of ml, as I have discussed the in calculations, we require 0.05 ml of the standard solution. So for that, I am taking this micro pipette, and now I will adjust it to 0.05 ml, that is 50 microliter. So here you can see this micro pipette, it is having the range between 20 to 200 micron liter. So now I require 0.05 ml, which is equal to 50 microliter. So I have adjusted this micro pipette to 50 microliter. Now I will take the sample, that is the stock solution. And now in this 10 ml volumetric flask, I will add it. Now I will adjust this volume to 10 ml. So now this is my dilution, 10 units per ml. I will just pipette it out in this test tube. So my this dilution, that is 10 units per ml dilution, is ready. Similarly, if I want to prepare the dilution for 16 units per ml, as per the calculations, I require 0.08 ml. So I will adjust here the reading to 0.08 ml is equal to 80 micron liter. So I have adjusted here the reading to 80 micron liter. I will take this stock solution. So here is the volume of 80 micron liter.
pipette it out. And then adjust the volume to 10. So my this solution will be 16 units per ml. So likewise you have to prepare the other dilutions as per the calculations.
Now we will prepare the plates for the assay. Similarly, I will prepare the next plate. Now I will allow this plate or the agar in this plate to solidify, and then we will make the cavities. So now the plates are solidified and I have added the diluted bacterial sample. Now I will spread the diluted bacterial sample using spread plate technique. So I am spreading this with a spreader. And I will keep it aside. Then I will take this second sample, but before that I will sterilize it. Now I have sterilized this spreader. Allow it to cool. And then I will spread this bacterial sample. Now we will make the cavities or the cups which are required for the cup plate method. So this is the agar plate I have taken, and this is the syringe with which I am going to prepare the cups. Now here you can see the syringe, I have cut it half, and with the help of the sharp edges I will prepare the cups. So likewise you have to prepare the cavities. Here you can see. Now we are preparing the second cavity. Slowly you have to prepare. Here you can see I have prepared the second cavity. So likewise you have to prepare the cavity for all the dilutions. So here you can see I have prepared the five cavities
And now I will add the antibiotics solution of different dilutions in this.
Now we will add the dilutions in the cavities. So now I have adjusted the volume to 0.04 microliter as per the capacity of the cavity. Now this is the dilution 10. So now I am going to add. This dilution 10 in this cavity, because this is marked 10. Similarly, I will take the dilution 12. That is 12 units per ml. Then this is the third dilution, dilution 14. Now I will add this in cavity number 14. This is the dilution number 16. Equal volume should be taken, otherwise it will affect the zone of inhibition. And now this is the unknown sample which I have prepared. So based on the calibration curve obtained from the standard sample, I will determine the concentration of the unknown sample. So now this is the cup plate method which we have seen. Now we will perform the filter disc method. So for filter disc method, I have sterilized this filter disc and I have sterilized its forceps. So with the help of this forceps, I will place the filter disc on this agar plate. So I will take the first disc. I will dip this in this solution. That is the 10 units. And now I will place this on this agar. Again, I will take the second disc. And I will dip it in the second solution. And now, I will place it in the second cavity or second section. So likewise we have placed all the disc, and now these two plates we are going to place in refrigerator for 2 hours for the diffusion of the antibiotic into the agar. So now I am placing these plates into the refrigerator for 2 hours. Now the 2 hours are over. Now we'll place these plates in the incubator for incubation at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius for 24 to 48 hours.
So I hope you have understood how to perform the microbiological assay of antibiotic using couplet method or filter disc method. So we will see the procedure now. So first is dissolve 256 mg of streptomycin sulfate in 100 ml of sterile water. From this, take 1 ml and dilute it to 100 ml, and each ml of this solution contains 20 units of activity. Accordingly, prepare 10, 12, 14, 16 units per ml of the standard stock solution. Then prepare the unknown solution in the same solvent as that of the standard solution. Sterilize the antibiotic assay medium. Now for streptomycin, the antibiotic assay medium required is medium A, and you have to prepare it and then sterilize it in autoclave and then prepare the petri plates. Then spread the test microorganism, that is the Bacillus subtilis, on the surface of the petri plate using spread plate technique. Then prepare cups or cavities using cork borer, or you can use the needle which I have shown you in the video. Or you can also dip whatever is the add standard test solution in each of the labeled cavity, or you can dip the filter disc in the standard solution and place it aseptically on the surface of the agar. Transfer all the plates to the refrigerator for proper diffusion of the antibiotics for 1 to 2 hours, and then incubate it at 32 to 35 degrees Celsius for 24 to 48 hours. So observation. So for couplet method, you will get a likewise zone of inhibition, and for filter disc method you will see likewise zone of inhibition. So just mark it with the marker and measure the zone of inhibition using the scale. So these were the results obtained. So for the unknown, the zone of inhibition in millimeter was obtained by 16.5. so likewise also here you can say that the concentration of unknown solution of test antibiotic is 14 units per ml. So the result is the concentration of unknown sample of streptomycin is 14 units per ml, and the microbiological assay was successfully performed of streptomycin using the couplet method and the filter disc method. So possible questions asked is, what is microbiological assay, or define microbiological assay? Explain advantages and disadvantages of microbiological assay. Then what is the composition of medium used for assay of streptomycin? That is, what is the composition of medium A? Then name the methods used for microbiological assay of antibiotic and explain in short the couplet method. And last question can be asked is, explain turbidimetric method of microbiological assay. So this should be explained with suitable diagrams. So this was all about the microbiological assay of antibiotic. Thank you, students, for listening.